Moscow's first reaction to the landing of American Marines in Lebanon, a spontaneous demonstration before the United States Embassy. In addition to signs of protest, many of the demonstrators presented petitions at the front door, but most preferred more public manifestations. It was Friday, a working day in the Soviet capital. The crowd was estimated at 100,000. Lots of them were youngsters, but a sizable turnout for the workers' paradise, which of course boasts full employment. Policeman's helping hand gets one youngster down. The police kept things well under control throughout, down to the last measured drop of ink hurled at the embassy wall, before the schedule called for orderly dispersal. Then, an odd sight in Moscow, some enthusiasts got carried away, and the police had to do some work. The Mideast itself settled to an ominous slow simmer as United States forces in Lebanon continued to build up, with some 10,000 Marines and paratroops securing the air and sea gateways to Lebanon. Supplies were hastily moved in and forces deployed as though a hot war might break out at any second. A thoroughly professional job, for the fear of military clashes had passed after the first few hours. Contact with rebel-held areas was carefully avoided. Russia reacted on the propaganda front, calling for an immediate five-power conference, and the only enemies proved to be Lebanon's hungry mosquitoes and the broiling sun. The Lebanese were friendly and curious. Hopes mounted that the warring factions would be impelled to reach a settlement, and that the threat to one Western ally would be lifted. The Mideast simmered, but the brew was still potentially lethal. Britain built up her forces in Jordan. From Cairo, Damascus, and Baghdad, a radio barrage urged Jordan's masses to rise up and kill the king. Large-scale American economic aid poured in to bolster the imperial regime, but the threat was unabated. In Syria, cheering throngs waited to acclaim Nasser, president of the United Arab Republic, guiding spirit of the pan-Arab movement that erupted last in Iraq. As the United Nations and the outside world debated, Nasser was returning from a hasty visit to Moscow, with his power at an all-time high. A man who might yet set the entire Middle East, perhaps the world, aflame.